Hello Southies, welcome back to the channel, and if you're new, my name is Cece, and today you're watching another speed build, and honestly, I should be welcoming myself back to my channel, because it has been a minute since I have recorded a speed build or any kind of video, and several reasons for that. Just life has gotten busy for me. YouTube and simming is a hobby, so it's one thing that I try and keep stress free. So if I feel overwhelmed in any way, I will take a break, play the game just to play the game, and record when I can. But in this build, I am doing an abandoned beach house here in the beautiful world of Sulani. And the idea is basically this house has been abandoned for several years, and now it's just sort of a place where the local kids hang out and have fun and do all those things that they're not allowed to do away from their parents. It is a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom home. And really with this build, I'm super interested to see what you guys do with it when I upload it to the gallery. I would love to see someone remodel it, clean it up, maybe do additions or just add to it. I tried to make it feel like it was made several years ago, like maybe when it was first built here, it might have been a really beautiful place, but now it's definitely dated and has a really old style to it. And I used the tile, the wallpaper from Sulani that looks old and tattered. And I tried to use a lot of old things, and you'll see later, I'm gonna make the roof look like it's a tin roof. So yeah, I try to make it look as if it's just kind of been worn down over the years. But yeah, that's the build. Let's talk just sort of life. As I said before, I have taken a pretty long break from YouTube. I haven't really posted anything, not even my Let's Plays. I've just been trying to take it easy. As I said, sort of life in general has kind of gotten on top of me, and I think that that's a sentiment that probably a lot of people share right now. 2020 was definitely a year of stress. I think most people can agree with that, but I do feel we're kind of breaking away from that stress, maybe hopefully getting into a more chill vibe. The holidays are coming up, which I think universally the holidays are a time where people just kind of feel a little bit more, well, I would say more excited, but there's probably some stress in there too. But it just, the holidays kind of come around, and there's this automatic kind of joy just sort of built into it. Just the world itself just seems a little bit happier. Maybe that's just me, but I do feel it does feel universal sometimes. So hopefully now that the holidays are upon us, I can kind of relax a little bit, maybe have some more time to film. I'm going to start dedicating maybe a day to just film as much as I can. As I said before, this is a hobby. I don't want it to feel like a chore. So as much as I would like to keep a really strict schedule and just sort of bang out the content, I want this to be fun. And it's no fun if it feels like you have to record. I know for me, there are definitely some things that I want to get into, some gameplay stuff. I did download or purchase the new Star Wars pack, and I haven't played with it at all. I haven't even played with any of the build by stuff. So I am thinking about doing maybe a little Let's Play series, maybe do it over on Twitch just to kind of play with it. I know by now you've probably seen people play it and seen all the ways that it could be played, but I don't know, I think it might be fun just to kind of dive into it, play with a little bit. I have in mind a sim that I would love to use. So I will probably look into that. Like, again, might bring it to the channel, might play it on Twitch and then break it up and bring it to the channel. Like I've been doing my Detroit Become Human series. So far I have 3 parts. Hopefully I'll put the fourth part up. It's already been played and cut down. I just haven't made it accessible to YouTube just yet, so hopefully I can get to that. But yeah, that's kind of been my life, just really just working and trying to get back into the swing of things. I recently had a birthday, so for me, my birthday kind of resets the clock for me. I know for a lot of people, New Year's sort of resets the clock, but for me, I feel like with each year, I want to feel like I've accomplished something. I have to say last year, I don't feel like I accomplished much. Well, I take that back. I actually got a promotion this year, so that was really cool. But it's been more of a headache than a blessing, and I'm just trying to kind of get in the swing of that. So that was probably the best thing that happened to me in this past birthday year. And this upcoming year, I'm just hoping things kind of not slow down, but become more manageable, and maybe something new and exciting can come my way as well. I've been going back and forth about buying a home. Currently I've been renting for the last 10 years, and what's really cool about renting is the fact that you don't have to pay for the maintenance of your home. You know, you don't have to worry about yard work, depending on what type of rental you have. Like for me, I live in an apartment complex, so the apartment management company handles all of that. If something breaks, I just call the maintenance and they come in and they fix it. The grass is properly cared for and all that stuff, things that I don't have to worry about. The downside to living in an apartment is you share walls with people. You know, you don't have control over when they come to cut the grass and landscape and all that stuff. You're kind of throwing money into an ether that you'll never see again with renting. Usually people like to buy because it's at some point it does become your home. Or you can, if you decide to move, you might make a profit off of it. You can pass it down to family. And so there are upsides to buying. For me, the downside is maintenance. I don't want to have to take care of a place, especially all by myself. But more and more, I'm thinking purchasing a home is the better idea. Of course, we do have the lovely Sims here, where I can build a house and move in using money cheats and just have fun doing that. Of course, I did build my dream house here. I'll be sure to link that in the description below so that you can see it. It's if I were to build my own home, it's the type of house that I would want to have. So again, this house is just meant to be an abandoned home. It's 3 bedrooms. I desperately tried to fit in 4, but I couldn't. It was too difficult. But as like I said before, I would love to see what you guys do with it. Maybe you can add an extension to it or work out a floor plan to make 4 bedrooms. Maybe one would have to be tiny. I do on the downstairs have that kind of room off to the side there that's kind of in the middle of the kitchen and the sort of living space. I was thinking that could either be a closet or a laundry room or an office, or it could be a bedroom, but there is no downstairs bathroom, so that would kind of suck if you put a bathroom down there having to constantly go upstairs to use the restroom. But I would be interested to see what you guys do with it. One thing that I loved about this build is that I built it right after we got the patch that gives access to the eco lifestyle sort of debug items. So all the trash that you see around Evergreen Harbor, if you have the eco lifestyle pack, I put as much of that in here as possible. It just really made the place sort of come to life in the sense of it looking like it's been abandoned. A lot of times those types of homes in The Sims, they still look kind of picturesque, but this kind of looks I wanted to feel like you walk in and you automatically feel gross. Like, I wanted to look like the place smells like mold and dirt. And what I'll probably do, and you'll see in the screenshots, because I don't think I really added as much as I wanted to before I decided to start editing and doing this voiceover, was putting a lot of candles in this place so that it looks like there's no electricity here. And I might just make the place off the grid for now. And that way it does kind of look like people just kind of come in, and maybe homeless people sleep here. And like I said before, the local townies come and hang out, the kids hang out here. And I put a lot of like scratches and stuff from the vampire pack on the walls and that kind of thing, and some Jungle Adventure cracks and stuff like that. And as you can see, I'm going through the debug menu. Probably my least favorite thing when I really wanting to bring a place to life is going through the debug menu, because it does take a lot of time. The catalog, as you probably heard in the past, is not... there's really no rhyme or reason to it. Like, you scroll and you scroll and you scroll, and there's no real like rhyme or reason to how it's set up, and that can be a little bit annoying. And I find that even when I filter, sometimes I don't get all the items that I want. So you kind of have to go and scroll and scroll and scroll through the debug menu in order to find what you want. But I actually did this build on stream, so I just kind of took my time with it. It was kind of like a lazy stream where I literally just sat and looked for debug items to put in this house. That particular day, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't too stressful, but I really do commend those builders that sit and truly just take the time to go through and find item after item after item. As you saw, I was kind of playing with some of those debug items. I just realized that with that update, that some of those sort of buildings that you see in the background beyond the university ones are now available. So like big office buildings, that kind of thing, are now available on the gallery to us. And that could definitely be a cool thing to have. I mean, obviously you can't have your Sims go into those buildings, but you could build something next to it and have them sit beside it, and that way you don't have shells. Like, say you want to build a townhouse, or you just want to build sort of a more commercial style building, but you want it to look like it's next to other buildings. You don't have to take up space with like building a shell. You could just build your building and plop one of those debug buildings next to it. Now you can see I am just trying to really make this place look as rough as possible. That it really does come to life with the vampire pack. So if you don't have the vampire pack, their build bind stuff is my favorite thing of that pack. The gameplay is a lot of fun. I do have a Let's Play on the channel where I've been playing with vampires. Hopefully I'll get back into that soon. But even if you don't like the actual gameplay of vampires, just the build by alone is worth the money for that pack. Just because for this reason right here, to be able to bring spaces like this to life, like all that vines and all those cracks and things like that, just really brings the room, brings the home to life. It makes it feel more lived in. When you're trying to do like abandoned or spooky, scary places, it definitely works. Stressful doing all of this, but still fun. It was fun trying to come up with a story for this house. Since I didn't have a family in mind, I was really thinking that the family abandoned it for some reason. Maybe the person that lived here died and didn't have anyone to pass it on to, and so the community have just kind of taken it over in a really sort of unorthodox way. Now I am like scrolling and scrolling and looking for those like trash items to really trash up the place, and you'll see once I find those and I start putting them in the build, it's going to really, really, really bring this build to life in the way that, or complete my vision, I should say. But yeah, it was a lot of fun to do. I'm trying to think of more housekeeping stuff just for the channel. I have in my mind kind of what I want to do. And you'll probably notice that nothing is ever really strict. Even before, when I was putting more content out more regularly, it wasn't really strict. And I'm just gonna have to sort of keep up that particular pace just with life. It's a bummer, but I'm really not able to have a super strict schedule. So if you're not following me on Twitter, where I post kind of most of my stuff, then you might miss out if you don't have notifications on or anything like that. So follow me on Twitter, because I always post my videos on there, or post links to my videos on there. But yeah, I want this channel to be fun and to be relaxing and to be interesting and for people to enjoy it. And by people, I include myself in that as well. I want to feel like I enjoy what I'm doing as well. And I hope that you can pick up on that. I think that people can pick up on when you're having a good time, especially YouTube. Even those channels where it seems like the person's really not doing a whole lot, they're just kind of showing you their day, because they seem to be real and really be genuine and genuinely enjoying themselves, it's interesting, right? So for me, that's what I hope you get out of what I do. That's why when I'm not feeling the best, I probably won't film and I probably won't post, because you'll hear it. I hear it in my voice when I'm not having a good time. And so, yeah, I feel like I'm kind of talking in circles right now. I will say that I am working on a video kind of talking about sort of the toxicity within the Sims community. It's obviously a very niche kind of issue. It's not huge, but it is there. And I put a post well over a month ago, a poll asking about it. And I think I got almost 500 respondents. And a lot of those people did feel that the community at times, at least on Twitter, can be a little bit toxic. And so I kind of wanted to address that in a separate video, kind of like my skin tone debate video, just sort of sit down and sort of talk about my thoughts and all of that. Love to still hear your thoughts. Drop me a comment below. What do you think? Do you think the Sims community on, or at least, you know, Twitter, Facebook, that kind of area, Discord, social media, is a toxic place? I will hold my own thoughts for the video. I don't want to share it just yet, but I just wonder, because I feel as a whole, I'll say this, as a whole, and I think we can all agree, as a whole, Sims community is really supportive and can be really fun to be a part of, especially for someone like me who doesn't really know anyone IRL in real life that plays The Sims. None of my friends really play it. They kind of humor me when I talk about it, but none of them really play the game. They don't play any video games. And so really the only people that I know that play The Sims are the people that I have met through social media, my internet friends, if you will. And so I love talking to them and seeing their creations and seeing what they do, which includes a lot of you, I'm sure. And so for me, it has been an overall positive experience. But you know, there are times when sometimes it feels a little bit negative and kind of goes against the positive spirit that the Sims themselves try to push, or try to convey. I won't say push, try to convey. And so, yeah, just sort of some thoughts. I'm still kind of working it out. Of the things that I want to say, because, you know, I don't want to add to any negativity myself, but I do want to address it, because I think that it's important, especially right now in this time when it just feels like everything is just in a dark place. it does feel that way, at least on the surface. And things like this, hobbies, outlets, should bring us joy. And bring us happiness, even if it's temporary. It should bring us happiness. And so that's definitely what I want to do with this channel. And I think that's what a lot of people want out of the game, is to just, you know, be happy and to escape and to have fun with your Sims and create a world outside of your real life. Whether your real life is really boring or really stressful or just not what you want it to be, or maybe your life is everything you want it to be and you just want to play The Sims just to add spice to it, you know, have affairs with your Sims, that kind of thing. But we are coming up on the end of the build. As you saw, I use a lot of debug, most items, mostly that eco lifestyle stuff that I think you can agree really brought this place to life, really gave the vision that I wanted this place to have, which is abandoned and gross. And so we are coming up on the screenshots. So if you enjoyed this build, please let me know by way of pressing the like button. Comment down below your thoughts, especially on the things that I talked about. And if you haven't already and you want to see more content from me, please subscribe. I try to post every week. I'm going to try and get back into the habit, not just Sims, but other things too, just to mix it up a bit. I would love for you to be a part of the Southie family. As always, my name is Cece, and I promise never to break your game. Bye.